Hey, how's it going? My name is Ross. I'm a PhD student at the Research School of Earth Sciences at the Australian National Uni. And today I'm going to be talking about ore deposit formation. An ore deposit is a local accumulation of minerals from which a product can be extracted for a profit. So this product can be many things like metals such as copper, gold, silver, or lithium, or things like that. Or it can be a material like limestone or silica. So everything that we use in modern life, if it wasn't grown, so it didn't come from a plant or an animal, then at one point it was a mineral in a deposit that we came along and mined. So ore deposits, they're not randomly scattered across the globe. They're related to the geological processes that happen in distinct geological settings, which are more broadly related to their tectonic setting. Different tectonic settings have different geological processes operating within them and therefore form different types of ore deposits. These processes are things that you've probably all heard of before. So they're magmatic processes, hydrothermal, metamorphic and sedimentary, and often they're a combination of these things. So if we take the tectonic setting that I'm standing in at the moment for an example. I'm standing in the Lachlan Fold Belt in southeastern Australia. So this is a subunit of crust that forms up a large part of southeastern Australia. And all these rocks here formed during the Middle Paleozoic, which is about 450 to 350 million years ago. They formed in an island arc tectonic setting. And predominantly are made up of sandstones and siltstones in something we call turbidite sequences, as well as further inland we have granites and other intrusive igneous rocks, as well as some extrusive volcanics and that sort of thing. So an island arc tectonic setting, as you guys probably know from previous videos, is at a convergent plate boundary. So this is where you have two plates moving towards each other, where the older, denser plate will subduct under the younger, less dense plate. As this plate is subducting, volatiles and other stuff in the subducting slab will move upwards into the mantle wedge, and this causes melting. Those melts that form there, geologists call arc magmas or arc melts. These melts can migrate up through the mantle into the lower crust, where they can stall just a couple kilometers below the surface. As they're sitting there cooling down, there'll become a certain point where water that was dissolved in the melt will be exsolved, so it'll leave the magma. And this is exactly the same process that happens when you open a bottle of soft drink. CO2, carbon dioxide that was dissolved in the water, suddenly exsolves from the water and makes the drink fizzy. These fluids, when they exsolve from a magma, are what we call hydrothermal fluids, and they can carry a lot of copper and gold with them. So this is how a copper and gold deposit called a porphyry forms. And the Lachlan Fold Belt, especially inland in central New South Wales near Orange and Parkes, we have a number of world-class porphyry copper deposits. These didn't just form randomly there, they formed there because the geological processes required to form them occur in this distinct tectonic setting. So as an exploration geologist, the first thing you need to understand before you start to look at for these deposits is you need to understand A, what geological processes are happening to form these deposits, and B, what tectonic settings and what geological settings these geological processes occur in.